Now that your floors have been restored and protected by SaniGLAZE, we recommend the following aftercare steps to maintain and protect that beautiful surface. Aftercare is the term we use to describe SaniGLAZE's recommended cleaning and maintenance that should be performed by your custodial staff to extend the life of our coatings. By following aftercare procedures, your floor will stay in the clean zone for years to come. It is important to understand the do's and don'ts of aftercare before you start the cleaning schedule recommended by your SaniGLAZE representative. Number 1. Use only the floor cleaning procedures, products, and chemicals recommended by the SaniGLAZE team, and make sure to mix the chemicals by the manufacturer's directions. Too little will not work, and too much will make your floors tacky, which will soon attract soil. We have listed all approved chemicals in the description below the video. Number 2. Set up a routine and periodic maintenance schedule and stick with it. Your SaniGLAZE service provider can recommend when your floors will need periodic maintenance. Staying ahead of the problem will make maintaining your floors easier in the long run. Don't wait until your floors are soiled to begin maintenance. Number 3. Use only a medium to soft bristle brush for scrubbing tile and grout. Use clean mops or microfiber flat mops, fresh mop water, and pH-neutral cleaning solutions. Number 4. Keep your mop water fresh and mopping tools clean. Number 5. It is important to dry mop and dry a wet floor before opening it up to foot traffic. Now that we know the do's, let's look at the don'ts. Number 1. Do not sweep, mop, or buff after initial restoration until the surface has cured, which normally happens within 24 hours, and do not machine scrub newly restored floors until 7 or more days after restoration. Number 2. Do not use mops that have cleaned other areas of your facility so as to avoid the risk of cross-contamination, which may create odor and other sanitation issues. Number 3. Do not use a wire brush or other highly aggressive brushes. No aggressive scrubbing pads, tools, or equipment for cleaning grout joints. Their use can harm the protective shield coating. Besides, cleaning is now more effortless, and it doesn't require overly aggressive treatment. Number 4. Do not use harsh cleaners, aerosol sprays, or timed room deodorizers containing acetone. Now that you understand the do's and don'ts, let's look at the recommended steps for aftercare. Aftercare comprises two types of cleaning: routine cleaning and periodic cleaning. Regular routine cleaning should be done on a regular basis. This means daily, weekly, or multiple times each day. It is similar to how you cleaned the floor before, but make sure to follow the previously mentioned guidelines to keep your newly restored floor in good condition. Periodic cleaning is an adjunct to routine cleaning and includes tasks that should be performed weekly, monthly, quarterly, or even annually. Over time, soil, film buildup, and other contaminants left behind from routine mopping will build up to a point where you'll need more than a mop to properly clean your floor. For daily regular routine maintenance, please follow these steps for best results and to keep your floor sparkling clean. Number 1. Sweep or vacuum loose dust and soil from the floors before mopping. Number 2. Use EverGLAZE Daily Cleaner or an appropriate neutral cleaner for your routine mopping schedule. Number 3. Rinse with clean water and allow the floor to dry. Note, no rinsing is required when using a microfiber pad and neutral cleaner. As previously discussed, depending on the traffic in the area, your floor will need weekly or monthly periodic deeper cleaning. Number 1. Periodic maintenance starts with sweeping or vacuuming any loose dust and soil from the floor before mopping. Number 2. For optimum results, mop with EverGLAZE Daily Cleaner and allow it to dwell for 15 minutes before scrubbing the floor with an approved scrubber and soft or medium bristle brush. Number 3. If any heavily soiled spots remain, pre-spot them and agitate with a soft bristle deck brush. Number 4. Vacuum up dirty water and cleaning solution with a wet vacuum, and then rinse with clean water. Number 5. vacuum up water, and allow to dry before allowing any foot traffic in the area.
If you follow these steps, your floor will stay in the clean zone for years to come.